How are government grants of special rights to be construed? Early in the nation's history, the Supreme Court wrestled with that question in Proprietors of the Charles River Bridge versus Proprietors of the Warren Bridge. In 1650, the Massachusetts legislature authorized Harvard College to operate a for-profit ferry across the Charles River between Charlestown and Boston. In 1785, the legislature incorporated the proprietors of the Charles River Bridge, which we'll call Charles, to build and maintain a bridge where the ferry landing sat. The act granted Charles the right to collect bridge tolls for 40 years, later increased to 70 years. Charles was to pay Harvard £200 a year to compensate for the lost ferry revenue. After the charter expired, the bridge would be surrendered to the state. In 1828, while the Charles Bridge Charter was still in effect, the legislature authorized the proprietors of the Warren Bridge, which we'll call Warren, to build another bridge only a few hundred feet from the Charles Bridge. The Warren Bridge would be surrendered to the state once bridge tolls covered its construction costs, but no longer than 6 years after opening. Afterward, the Warren Bridge would become toll-free, so people wouldn't need to pay tolls to cross the Charles River Bridge anymore. Charles sued Warren in the Massachusetts Supreme Judicial Court, first seeking an injunction against the erection of the Warren Bridge, then for damages after the Warren Bridge opened. The state court dismissed the bill of complaint, and Charles appealed to the United States Supreme Court.